If I say, I got this bottle of stuff that I think you'll like, it's bacteria juice. Would you drink it? Of course not. But if I said, drink this kombucha, mother made it, oh yeah, buddy. Hey everybody, thank you for watching DNews today. I'm Trace. Healing each other is in our DNA, it seems. As far back as we have historical record, we have mixed up elixirs and potions for every ailment. In the Odyssey, Helen is given Nepenthes Pharmakon, I don't know how to pronounce it, which is probably opium to heal her mind. Coca-Cola was marketed as a cure for a hangover. The modern version of this attempt to provide healing might be the word-of-mouth cure-all, like kombucha. Kombucha tea has been popular with holistic health proponents for decades, likely branching from centuries-old Asian medicine. If you've never seen it before, modern kombucha tea comes from a strange-looking container of brownish liquid with a blob floating in it. It looks like something H.R. Geiger would invent for a kids' movie. And if you're thinking, dear God, what is that thing? It's a symbiotic culture of bacteria and yeast, or SCOBY, floating in a brew of regular old tea and sugar. The yeast eat the sugars, just like they do in beer making, and create alcohol and CO2. Then ethanol is eaten by the bacteria and turned into acetic acid. The final result is a vinegary, acidic, slightly alcoholic, vaguely effervescent brew. In fact, if you leave it in there long enough, it'll become alcohol. And even longer, it'll become vinegar, which, if drunk like a beverage, can erode tooth enamel and cause digestive problems and ulcers. Science. A 90s Newsweek piece said it allegedly turns gray hair black, clears up bad skin, boosts T-cell count, and induces spiritual well-being, and clears up cellulite. Manufacturers claim it can improve liver, gallbladder, and digestive functions and enhance the body's normal toxin elimination process. The thing is, there is no actual medical evidence whatsoever that kombucha does any of these things. And believe you me, science is looking. One of the major manufacturers was sued for claiming health benefits and concealing health risks. I found dozens of studies looking at what is growing in that strange jar, and they found yeast and bacteria, which is not surprising. Depending on the source and geographic location, the species of the microbes could vary, which is not a surprise, and that depending on the brew, the pH level or acidity will vary as well. A compilation study in the Journal of Environmental Health for the FDA laid out all current knowledge and found kombucha isn't harmful, as long as you're already healthy. But you should never drink more than 4 ounces per day, according to the CDC. The real problem is the tendency for kombucha drinkers to make it themselves. Similar to home brewing of any fermented beverage, this will expose drinkers to dangerous levels of mold, bacteria, and fungi, which naturally live in our environment if done properly. It can be dangerous when allowed to culture for days at a time, which is how kombucha works. There are no proven scientific benefits to drinking kombucha at all, even after decades of searching. It doesn't seem like it would hurt you if you bought it at the store from what we could find, but it's not gonna help you much either, at least not according to science. Home brewing, on the other hand, is risky. If ceramic pots are used, for example, lead poisoning could result. If non-sterile conditions are used, contamination could cause severe illness. Do you drink kombucha? Tell us down in the comments and make sure you tell us why as well, and subscribe for more DNews every single day. Also, check out this video on why detoxes don't work, you know, if you're feeling like vengeful. Thanks for watching.